Welcome to FAR, the photographic series. In this series, we are going to guide you through cameras and photographers, their problems, their solutions, and a lot more. Do keep watching. Welcome to another episode of FAR, the photographic series. So today we are going to talk about different types of equipments and cameras used for commercial photography, that is interior and architectural photography. So basically, from starters, if we start, this is what we require to capture still objects and not human beings. So obviously the thing has to be very, very still and stable. There is no kind of motion in the picture. So for this kind of photography, we use a tripod. Generally, we use an on-camera remote through which we do not catch the camera or we do not move the camera after setting it into an angle. The only purpose for doing this is that when we press the shutter also of the camera, there is a slight vibration which we need to avoid while doing a shoot of such. For this, the ideal lens would be a 16-35mm or a wide angle, that is a 14mm block lens. This can be used in different kind of ways. We ideally use this so that we get exactly the entire angle of the frame. We usually shoot at an f22 or an f20 for this, so that the perspective remains similar and we get an ideal perspective of the entire frame properly, that is in the full pixel of it. For this, we need to have adequate lightings too, because if you're shooting at an f22, obviously there is not enough light in a room that you would be able to shoot on that. So for that reason, we usually increase the ISO slightly, but not too much, so that we avoid noise, and we decrease the shutter speed. So usually we shoot at a shutter speed of 3 seconds or 5 seconds or 10 seconds as per the lighting in the room. For that reason, since the shutter is very low, obviously there can be no vibration that can be caused to the camera. Because if there is even a slight vibration, there will be definitely one part of the frame that is blur, which we cannot afford when we are doing interior photography. Secondly, when we are doing interior photography, we have certain things like when we are shooting a room and it has a balcony. So obviously there is an outdoor sky or there is a view. Maybe it's a sea view, maybe it's a pool view, it can be anything. So what happens in this case is you cannot get the exposure right of all of it together in one frame. So in this case, we use an HDR kind of a mode. In this mode, what we do is we shoot three different exposures. An exposure that is perfect for the outdoor, an exposure that is perfect for the middle part of it, and an exposure that is perfect for the closest part of the camera. After shooting this, we need to Photoshop it and erase the part that is not in the right exposure. This gives the ideal frame. There's obviously a lot of work to it. There's a lot of editing process involved in it. We have to avoid shadows, we have to avoid extra lights that are coming into the zone, erase it out, so you need an expert retoucher for this. Without that, it would not work. Also, not only this, but while you are shooting interiors and architecture, you also have to keep in mind the components and the composition of the frame. You always have to tell your clients what is required in the frame and what is not. Because since you are capturing everything on a whole, you have to take care that what is looking good in the frame. If needed, change positions of maybe the sofa while you're shooting, or maybe the TV set while you're shooting. The showpieces that are lying around, place it well. There should be no random towels lying, clothes, shoes, etc. lying all around the place. The only reason being for that is it looks very untidy in the frame. So you need to take a lot of care about these components too while shooting interior and architecture. The second point of interior and architecture shoot is using a drone. When you have to shoot an entire building from outside, obviously you cannot shoot it with a wide angle camera, or you maybe need to go to another person's terrace and shoot an entire building. So for this, preferably people use drones in today's day. Drones are ideal for shooting entire buildings or shooting entire landscapes. They are also ideal for shooting real estates. Today people use the drones for creating something called a virtual tour or a 360 degree view of flats for sampling or for other things like that. So today, this is the most trending thing in interior and architectural photography. In case you want to become an interior photographer, you need to tie up with some kind of magazine or a booklet that would give you an opportunity for the same. Builders and architects would also be a good choice because they're looking to make their portfolios in the same region. In case you have any questions, any queries, anything that you want to ask us, please do mention it in the comment box below, or you can contact us on info@bxstudio.in. If you like the content of this video, please make sure you like, share and subscribe. Hey friends, this is A.Roshan, your very own house friendly photographer. We are going to talk about a lot of camera techniques, problems faced by photographers and a lot more throughout this series. So do keep updated with the Fire series.